Here are some pictures of contaminated 300mm HDP domes. The following dome scrub procedure is FoamTech International's high-precision PM technique that eliminates the high cost of having to replace the HDP dome. Depending on the process, HDP domes can be replaced as often as every 5,000 wafer hours, relating into high costs and extended tool downtimes. In normal circumstances, our HDP dome scrub kit will efficiently scrub the dome in under an hour. Depending on the wafer count and the technician's discretion, either a 180 diamond scrub pad or a 360 diamond scrub pad can be used. Using proper procedures and guidelines, prepare the HDP chamber for dome scrub. It is recommended to cover the HDP chamber to prevent particles from being reintroduced back into the chamber. Properly stage FoamTech International's HDP dome scrub kit, including a small container of DI water. Dampen the Ultrasolve sponge in the container of DI water and proceed to wipe down the HDP dome, removing any loose contaminants. Attach the 180 diamond scrub disc to the ergo handle and dampen with DI water. Using the ergonomically safe handle with dampened scrub disc, proceed to scrub all areas of the HDP dome, concentrating on the heavy deposition buildup. Understand the objective of this procedure is to remove the sharp deposition buildup that accumulates throughout the dome. These areas of heavy deposition buildup will be apparent as the scrub disc is audibly more scratchy over the roughened surfaces. As the scrub disc begins to accumulate with deposition, it is important to unload the scrub disc by pulling across the dampened Ultrasolve sponge. This step will help prolong the life of the scrub disc. Using the dampened Ultrasolve sponge, proceed to wipe the HDP dome free of deposition. This important step will significantly reduce the vast number of wipers that would normally be needed to perform this procedure. Continue to repeat this procedure, scrubbing all areas of the HDP dome. Ensure to unload the diamond scrub disc as necessary onto the dampened Ultrasolve sponge, and use the dampened Ultrasolve sponge to wipe down the HDP dome. As the Ultrasolve sponge begins to load up with deposition, rinse the sponge out in the container of DI water. Dampen the 180 diamond scrub pad in the container of DI water. Using the same technique as described before, proceed to scrub specific areas throughout the dome where heavy buildup may have accumulated. This may include the vacuum sealing surface around the edge of the dome. Remember, the objective of the dome scrub procedure is to remove the sharp deposition buildup that has accumulated throughout the dome. It is not necessary to try to completely remove the deposition shadow. You simply want to drag the back of your hand across the surface of the dome, ensuring the roughened deposition has been removed. In preparation for the final wipe, take a cleanly rinsed Ultrasolve sponge and wipe down the entire dome. It is important to use a lightly dampened Ultrasolve foam wipe when performing the final wipe portion of the dome scrub procedure. This is because Ultrasolve foam wipers will not shed fibers when wiping the ceramic dome. In order to properly saturate the Ultrasolve foam wipes with DI water, fold the foam wipe into quarters and apply DI water directly onto the wipe. Due to the characteristics of the foam, the DI water will need to be carefully worked into the wiper. Taking the lightly dampened Ultrasolve wipe, proceed to wipe the HDP dome by pulling the Ultrasolve wipe across the dome. Refold the wiper as necessary to continue exposing a fresh, clean portion of the wiper. Using the same wiping technique as before, ensure to wipe down all areas of the ceramic dome, including the ceiling surface. To ensure proper tool recovery following the dome scrub procedure, it is important to use the HT5790S mirror wipe to wipe out the HDP chamber. First, take an HT5790S mirror wipe, fold into quarters, and saturate with DI water. The tight microfiber characteristics of the mirror wipe will make this wiper appear non-absorbent, but it's these characteristics that make the mirror wipe much more efficient in removing the submicron particles left inside chambers. The DI water will just need to be initially worked into the mirror wipe to become saturated. Take the saturated mirror wipe and proceed to wipe down all areas of the HDP chamber. Ensure to concentrate on all the critical areas, such as the upper region between the injector nozzles, the lower regions above the turbo pumps, and underneath the lip around the E-chuck. Ensure to replace the mirror wipe as necessary and saturate with DI water accordingly. It will be important to use the mirror wipe to wipe out all sealing surfaces throughout the chamber, including the O-ring grooves. In this example, a tool is used with the mirror wipe to effectively wipe out the captive O-ring groove. FoamTech International has recently developed a mirror swab to be used specifically for this application. After performing the final wipe portion of the dome scrub procedure, using proper procedures and safety guidelines, return the HDP chamber back to production.